Hey, good morning, everyone. My name is Eric Schaefer. I'm a firefighter with South County Fire. We're based out of Everett, Washington. We're here today in Appleton to do a final inspection on two pumpers. Our organization is 15 fire stations. We serve a population of 300,000 people, and we serve 57 square miles. So we'll do a quick walk around of our pumper here. Recently, we added locks to all the compartments, so all the doors in the compartments after having a lot of tools stolen while on the scene of fire emergencies. We went ahead and added the black interior. We were originally gray, but we saw a truck here on the blue floor last time when we were doing a final inspection and thought that it would be a good feature to add to us, and we're really pleased with how it came out. We also run pull chains for our air horns. It's kind of a throwback to the old school engines that we wanted to incorporate into our fleet. So in the back of the cab, we have seating for two firefighters with SCBAs built into the seat. We also have three-quarter height EMS cabinets that store some of our small equipment, and we have a full shelf across between the two cabinets to store any other miscellaneous EMS equipment like gloves and masks, so on and so forth. All right, next up we have our transverse compartment doors here. We have all of our long tool storage for our tubes, so we'll have two hooks that come out of each side. We have some other small tools that we'll carry on the flat spot, and then we'll have a dry chem and water extinguisher on either side. Next up is our pump panel. We really put a lot of focus into our pump panel. We run 50 PSI nozzle tips. We have a low pressure hose system. We went ahead and we're using FA gauges. They have a 1% accuracy. We went with a 6-inch 400 PSI gauge versus a 600 gauge that's typically ran so that we can dial in our pump pressures very accurately. We also have 400 PSI discharge gauges as well so that we can dial in those nozzle pressures. We worked very hard and had specific directions for all of our pickups for the gauges so that no matter how the line was gated, we were reading 100% true accuracy on our discharges. Another thing that's unique to these new pumpers is that we have an Akron auto tank fill. It allows us on our bread and butter fires, you know, one or two line, we can hook into a hydrant and we never have to do a changeover. So the person on the nozzle will never see a fluctuation in pressure as we change from tank water to a hydrant. And what it allows us to do is that as the tank drops down to 50%, the auto tank fill will fill the tank back up to 95% and turn it off at that point in time. We also have our TFT 4-inch intake here for going directly into the eye of the pump. So one other new thing that we have changed for us is on these pumpers is that we've eliminated the crosslay. Our department is strictly pulling lines off our bulk bed off of the rear. So we're gonna go ahead and utilize this area here, the compartment here, that allows us to have some backboard storage. We put our foam up there and as well as some hazmat cleanup supplies on top there. Figured it would be a good space that we could utilize since we didn't use it for hose lines. And then obviously on the top up there, we have our deck gun and then a hose reel with 150 feet of hose on it. We were traditionally a lap door department. We've actually transitioned over to roll-up doors because we do a lot of emergencies on the freeway. So for safety aspects, we went ahead and went with roll-up doors so that we don't have any blind spots when we're pulling out on the freeway. We don't have to get blocked. This will be our engineer's compartment. Some of these shelves will be adjusted and we'll mount all of our fittings up there. We'll have our rick bag in here and other miscellaneous stuff for the driver to handle. Next up, our over-the-wheel compartment here. The driver will have their pack mounted vertically in the left here and then some small ancillary tools over here as well. Next up in the rear compartment here, this is where a bulk of our tool storage is at. We've run to an all-electric complement. We'll have an electric chainsaw, electric circ saw, electric vent fan, electric scene light, some traffic cones, and then there'll be a rapid four-bank battery charger in there to keep extra batteries for the crews to use on scene. All right, so this is truly where we started designing the truck from, and that was the hose bed. When we first designed the spec, we started at the hose bed and we built the rest of the truck around it because this was the most crucial point to our operations, and that's fighting fire. So off the back of here, we're running 600 feet of key 3-inch hose. We have a 300-foot key combat sniper with a 50 PSI 7/8 tip that's pre-connected to this bed for going extra long. Then we run at 2 1/4, 200 feet. We have another 2 1/4 at 200 feet. We have 3 2 1/4 mid-rise bundles. We'll have another 2 300-foot inch and 3/4 key combat sniper followed up by a split bed of key 4-inch high flow hose here at 800 feet. So we have plenty of hose to go long stretches throughout. And then we also added, we have a rear air dump. Our current hose bed height is at 62 inches. We have an air dump that will drop the back of this another 4 inches down. So in the back compartment here, we'll run some peat zorb for our auto accidents cleanup after oil. We'll have a hydrant bag. We run an Elkhart blitz monitor, and then we'll have our mid-rise bag with all the fittings and everything in here. All right, this is another key feature that we changed on these trucks is that we used to have a full high side compartment here with a ladder rack. Our area is getting tighter and tighter. So with the clearance for our ladder rack coming down, we switched to the low side ladders. So we have a Zico ladder rack that'll actually come down to about this height here for the top of the ladder. So anyone at any height can grab the ladders off of there. In the back of here, we'll have our lap doors. Because we have a low side body here, we went with lap doors on this side to gain full compartment space so that we didn't lose any with the roll-up door. But this compartment here will house all of our EMS equipment. It allows our firefighters to get out, be off of the roadway, obtain all of our EMS equipment, and then respond in on that. We have two compartments for storing spare SCBA bottles here. And then this compartment here will be strictly for the officer's bunker gear. We'll be able to store everything there, and then they also have a set of ballistic vest and helmet in there for the emergencies that call for it. So on the officer side pump panel here, we have our access to our hose reel. We have another access to our transverse upper compartment here. And on this side here, we have our TFT intake valve that's operated by an electric control, so it can be controlled from the other side. But with all of our mid-rises and everything that we have going in, we opted to have two LDH discharges off the pump on the officer side. But we added the 2.5 caps here so that if we're extending smaller lines or our 3-inch, if we're running that to an FTC, we can still hook those into there without having to adapt it. And then the bed here will get 35 feet of key 4-inch magnum hose for supply. All right, as we come around the front here, will be our fourth pumper that we have a front intake on. It'll have an auto 35 feet of key hose attached to it. We have a roto ray, which is pretty unique to our area. There's not many that are there, but we've determined that we needed something to draw the attention of drivers in our area, and we found that the roto ray was a cool way to throw back. We have a federal Q siren, and then lastly, we have a 100-foot bumper line here of key combat sniper that we'll attach. We use for car fires, dumpster fires, things of that nature. As you can see here, we've opted for an all-wheeling light package throughout the full truck. At nighttime, we do have a sensor for low emitting to turn on, so it dims down and allows us to not draw as much attention to the apparatus and potentially prevent some accidents from happening. I just want to thank everyone for coming and taking a look at our truck here today. We absolutely love how it turned out, and we can't wait for them to get back to us and get them in service in our community.